Dear student, in 8th chapter already we have studied the motion, equation of motion. Okay, and that was applicable for the horizontal motion, whether it was the motion of a bus, car, train or any other vehicle on a surface. Okay, that we have seen. Now here we are going to see the motion under the gravity. Under the gravity means it will be a vertical motion which is governed by the gravitational force. Okay, here whatever the motion it was there, acceleration it was there, that was due to the force applied by the engine of the vehicle. Now here the force applied in a vertical direction, that force will be the gravitational force, and hence there will be the acceleration which is by the due to the gravitation. So here everywhere in this equation A is replaced by G. This is G means acceleration due to gravity. So here the equations you are going to get the same, only the A is replaced by G. Now here S is representing the distance covered by the vehicle. When we have studied the horizontal motion, now we are going to study the vertical motion. In that motion, that distance will nothing but a height. Okay, height of the object, height of the tower, height of a building, whatever is there. So S is replaced by H. Okay, so we are going to get the relations like that. So everywhere in these three equations of motion, if you are going to replace A by G and S by H, we are going to get the three new relations, and these are the relations which we are going to follow for the motion under the gravity. Now to understand it better, I have taken here four different examples. Okay, so first example is taken that a ball is dropped. Okay, or it is released when any object we are going to release or drop, then we are not going to give any initial velocity. So initial velocity u will be zero here. Okay, when it is dropped, it is coming down. Coming down means its velocity is going on increasing, 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 and when it will touch the ground, that time it will have the maximum velocity. Okay, why its velocity is increasing? Because it is going in the direction of the gravity, and hence as the velocity is increasing, we know that acceleration is final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time. As the final velocity is greater than the initial velocity, you will be getting the acceleration will be positive, and this acceleration you have to take as acceleration due to gravity. We have already calculated the value for it, that is 9.8 meter per second square. In many of the problems, it may be given to you that g is equal to 10 meter per second square, which is the rounded value of this, okay, for the simplification purpose. Now, the second I have taken, that is, ball is thrown from the top of a building or top of the tower. When any object is thrown, thrown means some velocity is given to it, okay. So here u will not be zero, you will have some value. When u will be zero? When object is dropped or released, that time u will be zero. When object is thrown from some height, okay, so that time velocity, some velocity it will have. Now this is also the same motion as that of this, so here also the g will be positive, v will be maximum. Okay, now the third situation we are going to see that the ball is thrown vertically upward. Okay, when any object is thrown vertically upward, what it means? When object is thrown vertically upward, it means some velocity is given to it, and that will be the maximum velocity, because going up means velocity is going decreasing, decreasing and decreasing. When it will reach the maximum height, that time the velocity will become zero. Okay, at maximum height the velocity will become zero. Height is represented by h. Now as the final velocity is less than the initial velocity, g you will get here negative, and here you have to take the value minus 9.8 meter per second square if the value is not provided. If the value is provided 10 meter per second square, you have to take again minus 10 meter per second square, because it is the upward motion. When object is going up, velocity decreases. Now fourth type of the motion, when object is thrown and then coming back. Okay, when the object is thrown, okay, so it will have the maximum velocity. When it will go up, it will at maximum height, the velocity will be zero, and again it is coming down. So for this part of the motion, now it is ascending. So let us take t is the time for the ascent. So it is represented as ta. H is the maximum height reached. So u will be maximum and here v will be zero. Now for this upgoing motion, already we know g value is negative. When it is coming down, now for this part of the motion only, u will be zero, okay, because it starts coming down, okay, it will be zero and v will be maximum. It is the velocity when it strikes the ground. Okay, when any object is projected with some velocity, then it will strike the ground with the same velocity. So I can say that here this velocity will be equal to this velocity, as well as time for ascending or descending, it will be same because it is covering the same height. Okay, so TA will be equal to TD. So these are very important points to use it in a numerical.